Generative AI models are great, but have you ever wondered how to specialize them for a specific use case, to be a subject matter expert in whatever your field might be? Well, in the next few minutes, you'll learn how you can take an open source, large language model and fine tune it from your laptop. And the best part is, you don't have to be a developer or a data scientist at all to do this. What you might have noticed after using LLMs is that they're great for general purposes. But for truly useful answers, they need to know the domain in which they're working with. And the data that's useful for your work is likely useful for an AI model too. So instead of needing to provide examples of behavior to a model, for example, respond back as an insurance claim adjuster with a professional tone and this knowledge of common policies, you can actually bake this intuition into the model itself. This means better responses with smaller prompts, potentially faster inference and lower compute cost, and a model that truly understands your domain. So let's start this fine-tuning process with the open source project InstructLab. InstructLab is a research-based approach to democratize and enable community-based contributions to AI models and allow us to do it in an accessible way on our laptop, just as we'll be doing today. Now, there's three steps that I want to show you that we're going to be doing in today's video. So firstly is the curation of data for whatever you want your model to do or to know. Second, fine-tuning a model takes a lot of data, more than what we have time or resources to create today. So we're going to use a large language model that's running locally to help us create synthetic data from our initial examples that we've curated. And finally, we're going to bake this back into the model itself using a multi-phase tuning technique called LoRA. Now, I mentioned the first step is that curation of data. So let me explain how this works in my IDE. Now, I've already got InstructLab installed. The CLI is iLab. And we'll do an iLab configuration initialize to set up our working directory. We'll set some defaults for the parameters of how we want to use this project, and we'll point to a taxonomy repository. This is how we're going to structure and organize our data. And we'll also point to a local model that we can serve locally to help us generate more examples. And just like that, we're ready to start using InstructLab. Now, I've actually got this taxonomy open, and you can see it here on the left. This is kind of a hierarchical structure of different folders to organize the information we want to provide to the model in skills and knowledge. So let's check out a skill. So this is a YAML formatted question and answer document in plain text. So I could be anybody to contribute to this model. You don't have to be a data scientist or an ML engineer. And I can provide this to essentially teach the model new things. For example, this is to teach it how to read markdown formatted tables. So we have context. We also have a question, which breed has the most energy, and an answer. As you can see here, we've got a 5 out of 5 for the Labrador. So we can use this as sample data to generate more examples like this and teach the model something new. Now, this is really cool, but I also want to show you teaching the model about new subjects as well. So the 2024 Oscars has happened, but the model that we're using today doesn't know that. We need to fix that. So we're going to ask this model a specific question from this training data that we want to provide. Specifically, what film had the most Oscar nominations? Now, I can do an iLab model chat in order to talk to a model that I have running locally. This is Merlinite 7 billion parameters. It's based off of the open source model Mistral. And we'll ask the question, which film had the most Oscar nominations? And unfortunately, The Irishman is incorrect. The answer is Oppenheimer, and it's our job to make this correct. So what we're going to go ahead and do is use this local training information and curation that we've done from our local machine and create more synthetic training data and also point to this seed document here at the bottom. This is markdown formatted information that we're going to pull during this data generation process that provides more context and information about the specific subject that we're going to teach the model. So let's get started. Now it's time for the magic to happen. So these large language models, as you might know, have been trained extensively on terabytes of data. And what we're going to do is use a teacher model that we've already served locally to generate hundreds or potentially thousands of additional examples based on our seed data that we provided. So let's kick this off. We're first going to do an iLab taxonomy and make sure that everything is formatted as it should be. And we've got back that smiley face, we're good to go. So what we're gonna go ahead and do now is start generating that data. So I'll do an iLab data generate, and specifically we're going to generate 3 instructions here using that locally served model, or we could point to one that's running remotely. And we're going to search for that Oscars question and answer pair that we've provided, and it's going to generate more similar examples to have enough training data to fully train this model. So this is really cool because it's creating different variations of our initial training data to be able to train this model in the end. And as you see here, we've generated three examples. You can see who was nominated for the Best Actor Award, and we're providing, or we're getting back this answer of these different actors. And what's great is that there's a filtration process because not all data is good data. With that newly generated data, it's time for what's known as parameter efficient fine tuning with InstructLab. So I'll go ahead and do an iLab model train. And what this is going to do is integrate this new knowledge and skills back into the new model, just updating a subset of its parameters as a whole, which is why we're able to do so on a consumer laptop like mine. So we've done some cooking show magic here to speed things up, since that process might have taken a few hours depending on your hardware. But finally, our result is a newly fine-tuned model specialized with the knowledge that we gave it. So let's go ahead and see it in action. In a new terminal window, I'm going to go ahead and serve the quantized version of this model so it can run locally on my machine. And we're going to go ahead and ask it a question, which I think you know what it might be. What film had the most Oscar nominations in 2024? So let's open up a new window and do an iLab model chat. And we're going to talk to this model to ask it this question. So what film had the most Oscar nominations? Oppenheimer. So it's really incredible to see the before and after of doing this fine-tuning process. And the coolest part, we're not AIML experts. We're just using open source projects like InstructLab, among others out there that can aid with the fine-tuning of large language models. Now, with this fine-tuned model, a popular way to provide external and up-to-date information would be to use RAG, or Retrieval Augmented Generation. But you can also imagine doing automated or regular builds with this fine-tuned model when the static resources change. So one more thing. We believe that the future of AI is open, but what does that really mean? Well, the InstructLab project is all about building a community of AI contributors, being able to share your contributions upstream and collaborate on domain-specific models. Now, what does that look like? Well, imagine that you're working at an insurance company. You could fine-tune a model on your company's past claims and best practices for handling accidents to help agents in the field and make their life better. Or maybe you're a law firm specializing in entertainment contracts. You could train a model on your past contracts to help review and process new ones more quickly. But the possibilities are endless, and you're in control. With what we've done today, you've effectively taken an open source large language model, locally trained it on specific data without using a third party, and now have a baked-in model that we could use on-premise, in the cloud, or share with others. Now, what are you interested in creating? Let us know in the comments below. Now, as always, thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to like this video if you learned something today, and make sure you're subscribed for more content around AI and more.